Hi, it's Handy Andy Tech Tips here, and today I'm going to show you how to build your own digital music library that you can play on your PC and phone, almost like your own version of Spotify, except better. So why would you want to do this? Well, streaming services are great, but they don't have everything. I found a lot of older tracks where the original version is unavailable on streaming, and the only copies are live versions, remixes, or re-recordings. Also, you can get better sound quality by building your own library. The original masters of albums from the 60s to the 90s were designed to be played on home hi-fi systems, and they have plenty of dynamic range. But the remasters found on streaming services are often made louder for car stereos and earbuds, and so they end up sounding worse when played on better equipment. Okay, so with all that said, how do you start building your library? Well, firstly, you should get hold of some CDs. The format is having a bit of a resurgence lately, and for good reason. The discs store DRM-free lossless audio, and they can effectively last forever. Next, you need to rip your CDs into your computer. Modern laptops don't have built-in optical drives, but external ones are easy to find. I have this Pioneer Blu-ray burner that also does a great job with audio CDs. Once you've connected your drive and inserted a disc, you'll want to download Exact Audio Copy, a free program for Windows that allows you to make very accurate rips. The link to the download page is in the description, along with a link to a very handy guide that will help you to configure it properly. Okay, so I've opened up EAC, and you can see that it recognizes my drive and it's showing the right number of tracks on the CD. Let's look at some of the most important settings. So go into the EAC menu and click EAC Options, then go to the Extraction tab. It's best to set the error recovery quality to medium. This means that if EAC encounters an error on the disk caused by a scratch, it will try to reread the damaged area several times. Next, go into the File Name tab. This lets you control how the ripped files are named. I like this format, which gives a two-digit track number followed by a space followed by the name of the song. Now we'll set the drive options. Go to the Extraction Method tab. This is where you tell EAC how your drive reads disks so you can get an accurate result. Don't worry if you're not sure what all these checkboxes mean, but if you click the Detect Read Features button, then it will test your drive and set up things automatically. Okay, so on to the compression options. And here we can set up EAC's built-in FLAC encoder. FLAC stands for Free Lossless Audio Codec, and it's a way to get perfect quality audio with roughly half the file size of an uncompressed WAV file. So I'd recommend enabling this, and then down here check Delete WAV after compression so you don't get two different copies of each song. Now finally, go into the metadata options. I found that the best metadata provider is one called MusicBrainz, so we'll select that from the list. Well done, you've configured EAC. Now it's finally time to rip the CD. First, it would be nice if we could automatically fill in the file names. So go to Database, Get CD Information From, Remote Metadata Provider. Just click Yes here, and then it will search MusicBrainz to find a matching album. I'll say that I don't want a cover image for now, we'll add one later. And bam, look at that. All the tracks have automatically been given a file name. To start the ripping process, click on the button to copy selected tracks compressed. Select a folder that you want to save the files in. I'll go here and then make a new folder with the same name as the album. Click OK and your optical drive will spin right up and begin extracting audio data. Okay, it's been about 10 minutes and the rip is completed. I'll click OK and it gives us a message that all tracks were accurately ripped, which is a good sign. And you can scroll up and see some additional information here. Now you can quit EAC and open up the folder where your ripped tracks were saved, and there they are. Now, the next stage of the process is to add metadata to the tracks. Well, didn't we just do that? No, this is different to what we did in EAC. There we were just filling in the file names. Now we'll add more information about the artist and album, along with cover artwork, to our files. To find and apply metadata automatically, I'd recommend using a free program called MP3 Tag. Despite the name, it works with FLAC files as well, and the download link is in the description. So open up the program, click on the Change Directory button, and browse to the folder with your rip, It's best to do this for each album individually. Select all the tracks with Ctrl A, and then go to Tag Sources, Free DB. Choose Determine from Selected Files, and you can see it's found three different matches for this album. I think the first one should be fine, so I'll go Next, and yep, there we go, all of our track titles. Apply that. So what have we got here? Well, we have title, artist, album, track numbers, year, and genre, all included automatically. But one thing that we don't have is the album artist. It's important to put this in because if you have multiple albums with the same title, for instance, Greatest Hits, then they might all end up being jumbled together. So I will fill the album artist in, making it the same as just the regular artist for all of the tracks, and then do Ctrl S to save. Okay, now we want the final piece of the puzzle, the album artwork. So go to Tag Sources, Cover Art, go to Music Brains here. Yep, we'll search the database for that album and artist, and there are many different results that come back. I'd recommend not going above 600 by 600 pixels for the artwork, otherwise it makes your files too large, and also the cover won't display in some media players. So we're going to the first result, and that's 1200 by 1200, too large. So we'll keep checking till find the right size. Here we go, 600 by 578, that'll do. Alright, so click OK, and all the metadata has been added. Good work. Now, a great program for playing back your music library on Windows is called FUBAR 2000. It's also free, and the link is in the description. Once you've opened the program, go into the Preferences, find the Media Library section, and add your music folder. Now, you could start playing tunes, but just before you do, I'd really recommend running Replay Gain on all your tracks. Replay Gain is basically a number that gets added to the metadata of a file, and it tells FUBAR and other media players how to adjust the volume of the track so that it sounds roughly the same volume as all your other tracks. So to run Replay Gain, right-click on All Music in the sidebar, and then go to Replay Gain, scan Per File Track Gain. FUBAR will come back with a list of numbers, and you can see that the track gains for this album are all over the place, some positive, some negative. And when you click Update File Tags, it will add the gain figures to the track metadata. It's not actually changing the contents of the file, it's just adding it to the metadata. Now you're done. You can sit back and enjoy your very own music library full of high quality tracks that you actually own. But what if you wanted to listen on your Android phone? Well, here's where things get really cool. There's a great app for Android called PowerAmp, which might just be the best music playback experience that I've ever seen on a phone. Moving your library over to an Android phone is quite simple. Just connect it to your PC via USB and drag the files across in Windows Explorer. Then go into the PowerAmp app on your phone, open the settings, go to Library, and select the folder on your phone's storage that holds your music. I'd also recommend, while we're in the settings, going into the audio settings and enabling Replay Gain, which will use that metadata that we added earlier in FUBAR. Now, PowerAmp has so many options for finding music. You can browse by all these different categories or just search for a song. And when you are playing back a tune, you get this beautiful interface with large cover art, waveform display that you can scrub through, and then you just swipe to move between the tracks. Notice that the colours in the background change depending on the cover art. It's just so aesthetically pleasing, this interface. If you want to change the way that the audio sounds, PowerAmp offers a complete set of controls including balance and stereo separation, and like a graphic equalizer and tone controls with all these nice little sliders. I mean, how awesome is this? It's really a power user's music app. And then you can even bring up the metadata for a song and look through all those tags that we added earlier. So there we have it. Now you know how to make your own version of Spotify, your own digital music library, and you can own the songs forever. Thanks so much for watching. I know that this was a bit of a longer video than usual. I'm Handy Andy, and please subscribe for more tech tips.